Alright, everything should be working, everything should be good, and with that, I can say, hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another live stream, and today, we're just gonna have some fun. That is pretty much all there is to this live stream. I just wanna have fun, and I wanna have fun with you guys along with me, so that's pretty much all there is to this live stream. We're gonna do some crap in Linux. I want to customize my Windows desktop, and I will probably also do some video editing as well today. Before we actually get to anything, I just wanted to show you guys where we're at right now, and by the end of the stream we can see if we actually have made some decent progress. So, let me just get rid of this for the moment. I can also... Yeah, you know what, I can just get rid of these pages. Doesn't really matter, I don't really need to have those on screen right now. What the crap do we have here? Oh yeah, we can just get rid of this. This I need for my music, so I'm just gonna leave that open. This is my desktop on Windows right now, and it is completely empty, and that's because I basically just turned off all of the... icons on my desktop. I really do not feel like having so many icons on my desktop anymore, so I just decided to get rid of them all and just have a nice clean desktop. Ever since I use Linux with a window manager, I just cannot go back to having icons on my desktop anymore. The result of this, however, is that I now have to go to my start menu every single time I want to launch an application. I personally am not a big fan of that, so I will have to clean up my desktop in a different way. So I would like to have a bit more of a custom desktop. So for that, we'll probably use Rainmeter for that. That allows me to get a very custom desktop layout, so I can have custom launchers for my desktop and whatnot. I can have all kinds of crazy stuff on there. But before we're gonna do anything of that nature, I just wanted to have a little bit more fun with Linux. Because I don't nearly get enough fun with Linux. Also, very unrelated to that, well, kind of related, is I've got a new terminal for Windows. I don't know why I felt the need to show you guys this, but this is something that I personally really like. This is a alternative terminal that you can use in Windows. That I absolutely love. Normally you just get a regular terminal like this, and well, this is not bad by any stretch of the imagination. This is not what I meant to do on here, I just want to get rid of all this. This is not a bad terminal by any means, but my personal gripes with Windows terminal is the lack of customization that you get with it. You get some good things with it, you get some nice stuff, but you're never going to be able to change the look of it or the feel of it or whatever. It's just gonna stay as it is. As for this, you can pretty much change whatever you'd like with it. So that's a pretty nice thing. I don't remember what this is actually called. I think it was CMD or something like that. But yeah, this is gonna be my terminal from here on out, probably. If I ever decide to run terminal-based applications, chances are I'll do it through that application. But anyway, for the time being, let's have a little bit of fun. I've been trying to mess with a different Linux environment as of recent. Like, I've been trying to launch into something called Void Linux, which is a very different kind of distro as opposed to what I've used in the past. But I figured it would be a fun experiment to try and get that to work. It was not a good time. It was not a fun experience. It was a really bad experience, as a matter of fact. It, for some reason, just would not work for me. And that's mostly because you need a root account to run it, which is obnoxious. I never recommend people use a root account with any of their Linux environments, because for one thing, it adds a little more clutter than what you would probably want to have on your desktop, but also it kind of locks down what you can do with your system. Because what you could previously do with sudo, right? You have a specific password that you can use for sudo applications, which is basically just a super user, right? And what you can do as a super user is you can do sudo, and then you can run an application as root, which is nice. And you wouldn't have to go into a root profile in order to run that command, which is really nice for a lot of people, I reckon. But for whatever reason, Void Linux forces you to have a root password, which is obnoxious, because now what you need to do is you need to go through a lot of hoops to add your user as a super user, which makes it pretty difficult to actually install software on your system. I tried, and I was not able to install software using the default settings for it. So yeah, that was pretty darn obnoxious. Okay, this is gonna take a while to boot up, so I might as well do something completely different. I could actually mess around a little bit with Windows XP, but I think I would much rather work on this right here for the time being. So let's do that. So I have not installed this yet. I did download the executable file, so I should be able to just find it in files and run it. And yes, I do use alternative file explorer, files v2, because I refuse to make use of Windows Explorer any further. It is a piece of trash. I do not like it. Alright. Yeah, we're just gonna install it in Dutch. Why not? Standard install. Oh, that's an excellent question. How much room do I actually have on my hard drive? Not a lot. I just watched Jurassic World Dominion. It was great. Nice to hear. That makes me very happy to hear. I could actually throw it on my junk drive. Yeah, I think I'll do that. Because I absolutely do not feel like keeping Raymeter on a hard drive like this. Or on my primary drive. I'm going to call this, we're just gonna call it Raymeter, why not? Alright. And install it on there. And sure enough, there we are. All done installing. And here we are. This is pretty much what Raymeter is going to do for us for now. You can actually change a lot of this stuff. Let's actually just unload that and hop into the Raymeter settings. This looks a lot different from what I've previously used, actually. I used this before to run some skins and stuff. Let's see what kind of stuff we can do with this. So I want to check out some Raymeter skins and install some of this stuff. The site seems to have some really nice things. This inside dream. Okay, that looks a that looks like a really cool thing. Actually, that kind of reminds me of a tiling window manager. And I can actually show you what that looks like. I think I should have it on my Arch install. Maybe not. What are the names of the two flags on your wallpaper? Oh, those flags are actually pride flags. So, the one that my mascot here is holding represents asexuality. And the one that my girlfriend is holding represents transgender. So that's pretty much what that means. But anyway, let's boot into Arch Linux, and I hope that this is the one with my tiling window manager. Because I think that should be it. Oh, nope, that's not what I meant to boot up. Let me get out of this. This is not the system that I meant. I think... Yeah, it could also be my Fedora instance, honestly. Okay, Chaos still doesn't boot up. And yes, I know that this is actually that Chaos is actually pronounced K-O-S, but I prefer to call it Chaos because that sounds cooler to me. Okay, I'll let that boot up. Chaos has a completely black screen right now, which is wonderful. That's just the kind of thing that you want to see, a black screen on your Linux instance. That's just wonderful. That probably means that I have to make some tweaks to it, or that I need to reboot my system, but I don't know, I don't really feel like doing that right now. But it's fine, if Chaos doesn't want to work with me, I could always just reboot it and see what happens from there, but... Yeah, that's weird. Alright, there we go, Fedora booted up. And yeah, I think Chaos just completely broke on me there. I'll try booting that up soon again, but let me first get into this. So I have BSBWM installed on here. And let's see what it looks like. Yeah, that looks about right. See, this is kind of what... that is kind of what this looks like to me. Like that bar and everything. This is supposedly the dock. And now it's even more like a dock. I can actually put that on the top of my screen and it would look exactly like a tiling window manager. Other than that, this doesn't really do tiling. This doesn't do tiling at all. You see, this actually does do tiling. So I can open up a terminal inside of here. I can do ls-al in here, and I can do several things like that. So I can run neofetch in there, and I can open a new one, and I can open up a htop inside of there, and you know, I can just tile everything up like this, which is really nice. It's always nice when you have things like that that you can just do without having too much hassle around it. Okay. I'm gonna try booting this up again, and I'm gonna throw it to my secondary display so that I can still see if it's going to work or not. I don't think it will, honestly. But there's only one way to find out. Just like with everything that you do in life. Just try it out, see what happens. Alright, So this is an example of a skin that I could use. What other things do we have? There's over 756. Oh my god. Yeah, let's run through some of this. They're stylistic. Oh my god, what's that? That's some pretty crazy stuff over there. Those are just some launchers. YouTube download interface. Oh god. That actually looks pretty cool. Oh. This is a Shield OS thing. I need to make this a little bit bigger on my second display. Okay, that is cool. Look at that, there's actually all buttons all over the... If you
have a brownie, you have a chance.
Ik ben aan het livestreamen.
Okay.
Hmm? Yeah. This is actually very futuristic looking. And I love the different layouts that you can do with this. I kind of want this. But I'm also kind of afraid that it might be a little bit much. Then again, my desktop as it is right now, it's completely empty, so it doesn't really matter. I can also just unload these things. The thing is though, if I want to do this, setting up these buttons, I mean, I've tried this kind of thing before where I would have all kinds of different buttons aside to a different application that I would want to run with those buttons. And the process of actually getting it is kind of a pain in the butt. But I'll keep this around on a secondary thing and leave it on there and see if I would... Okay, this is... I always love this. And now that I know what it actually is... are you making an Iron Man suit? No. No, that's not what this is. I would absolutely love to have a layout like this. Because this looks genuinely awesome. I just find the design a little bit unintuitive, so I'm probably not gonna use that. Yeah, this is more like a panel calendar kind of idea. There's Halo. That can be pretty cool. Dashboard 1.8. Let's see what we have here. Ah! Okay. Okay, okay. Battery indicators. I probably am not going to use that. I definitely do not need a battery indicator, but this is still pretty cool. Built-in calendar. But I kind of also want to have something that I can see my that I can actually click some buttons to launch an application. That would be pretty cool. Abby Reviews, welcome. How's it going? I was recently watching some of your stuff. You make some pretty good videos, from what I've seen. To be specific, I watched the worst SpongeBob specials list, I think. Yeah, love that video. That's really good. Okay, this has more of a Zelda theme. Okay, this I really like. What do we have here? Oh! That's an interesting layout. Okay, that's cool. You can actually have those buttons up there. I love that. Activity monitor there. Some actions. Dude, some of these are like macOS icons. Okay. That is like ultra minimalistic, but hey, maybe I can make use of that. Maybe that can be fun. Okay, this is more like my kind of thing. This actually has some application launchers down here. And it also has some of this stuff. That's really nice. Oh, everything is going to fit very well in here, and you can actually change certain things about it on the fly up there. Not quite sure how to feel about that diamond look though. I don't quite like that. What is this? Oh! Just as I'm looking over some more rain meter themes, Chaos has booted up. Or it's still kind of booting up, but we at the very least get a picture of it. We're getting something. Let's see what we're getting from it. We have a mouse cursor, so that's a good start. But we should also be able to see the desktop pop up. And there it is. So this is kind of their own spin on the KDE desktop. Let's hit the install button. I don't want to give this too much of a test drive before we actually install it on here. Once it's installed, we're going to give it a shot. We're taking it on for a spin and see how well this is going to work. Okay, I'm actually getting way further than how it went last time that I tested this out. Because last time that I tested this out, the entire desktop would just go completely dark and I would be all like, oh, what the crap is going on? Why can't I suddenly see anything? So, yeah, that was a little bit weird. Yeah, I need an English. Yes, default. That's fine. I don't want to install an office suite on here, I think. We can also just get a minimal desktop. But I don't think I'm gonna do that for the sake of this stream. Let's just install everything aside from office suite. We can always install that afterwards, of course. So it doesn't really matter. Okay, that is an obnoxious name. I'm just gonna call it Koen Chaos VM. Oh! It's clear that this is meant for a tablet or a phone or something. Maybe that's what that is. But I could be wrong. Yeah. Yeah, that's all perfectly fine. The main reason, actually, why I wanted to use this particular OS is because this is, for one thing, this is a independent project. I also would like to have the log on here so I can see what is going on. It has the Pac-Man Package Manager to install programs on it. And it's got a lot more stuff going for it that I find very fascinating and I would love to try out. So that's what we're gonna do. Let's see what other things we have on here. These are some application launchers, it looks like. These are just some folder icons, so I can open folders with this theme. That's a shame. This actually looked way more expensive than what it actually looks. Than what it actually is. Sorry. What is this? Oh. What the crap is that? Okay, sure. These are once again some hyperlinks to some websites that you can open. I mean, I'm sure I can assign specific applications to those buttons as well, but... Okay, this is Bricks. That is clearly an application launcher thing right there. But there's gotta be more like this. Unimix! Oh, wow, that looks really cool, actually. Let's see. Oh, yeah, these are just, again, some folder icons. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna try these. I'm gonna try this one. So we're just gonna install that. I have no idea how installing anything using Rainmeter works again, so I would have to figure that out, but... you know, there's only one way to find out, and that's to actually try it. You don't know how anything is going to work unless you eventually just go out your way to try this out. So, yeah, I'm just gonna close this for a moment. Hopefully, it's just as easy as that. All right. Excellent. So I just hit the install button. And, oh, good lord. That adds a fair few layouts to it. Okay, cool. And we're gonna install that. There we go. Oh, okay. That immediately just does it. I did not know it would immediately do this. Okay. I kind of want to check some things out here. What are these skins? This is just for adventures. Oh, yeah, okay. I see what is going to happen here. So I need to edit a few things about a lot of this. Okay, I would first like to unload this for a moment. What is everything? I didn't think that it would actually load all of this stuff up at once. That is hilarious. But also not so hilarious, because now I kind of need to figure out exactly what is going to work on here. Bridge control. Okay, let's test some things out. I want to see if any of these buttons work. Like, I'm definitely not going to try any of those buttons. But, oh, this is also overriding. Okay, this isn't, this isn't blocking any of my background applications, but, or my taskbar. I should honestly just make it so that the taskbar is always on top. Because that is going to drive me nuts. If it isn't constantly on top, then... Okay. Or I could just have it automatically hide itself. Right? Do that for me, please. Okay. Okay, there we go. Yeah, see, that's a lot better. Let's see if any of these buttons work. Okay, that works. Photoshop, does that work? Doesn't look like that works. What the crap? Okay, sure, man. Steam. That apparently does not work. You can't win them all. Okay, yeah, that works. Yeah, okay. I can actually get by with some of the stuff that that we have on here. But some of this I genuinely do not want to have on my system. So I'm just going to... Is this... Okay, yeah, I can also just unload that. What is this? That can just... stay where it is, right there. Okay. What the crap is this even? Oh, that just takes me to my home directory. I definitely do not need that. Let's get rid of that. These buns can go. What is this? I think this is some kind of volume control, right? Yeah, I think that's volume control. Oh, we have a little media player down here. That's nice. Yeah, let's also just get rid of that. A lot of this stuff is honestly really unnecessary. It's nice that we have a little clock down here, though. Okay, this is just a little countdown to the next year. I definitely do not need that. This is a battery indicator. Date and time down there. You see, the thing with this, with some of this stuff is that it's going to be really difficult to see. It's already really difficult to see because it's, literally just... Okay. Yeah. It's literally just gray text. So it's already really difficult to see. That is CPU usage. Which is also being displayed on here. I also want to get rid of you. Yeah, this is also not going to do it for me. Time and date. Yeah, that's just internet speed. I also do not need that. And there we go. So now we have just a rather simple layout on here. Yeah, I can also just get rid of this. CPU usage, I'm never gonna use that at all. This I think is my trash can, right? Yeah, that's my trash can. Alright. What do we have here? Oh, these are some games that I do not have on here. Paradise City I do have, but the other games that were in that list I did not have. Alright. So let's have some fun with this. What do we have on the dock? Oh wait, what the crap? Did I just tell you that I don't want to have all this on my screen? Let's also get rid of this thing. And there's still a little thing over here that I do not want to have on my desktop. Why does some of this stuff just come back when I don't ask for it? Because I swear to God, I just got rid of this thing. Okay. Perhaps. Good Lord. Okay, and this right here is the dock. I should have other options for that dog, right? I know I should have. Meanwhile, on the other side, we have Chaos that just decided to crash on me, so I don't know if the installation actually made it through there. Yeah, it definitely did not. Alright. That is not going to work for me then. And this is also definitely not going to work for me. Okay. I kind of just want to make... I just kind of want to get rid of this. Nah, I cannot do that with this. There's way too much stuff on it, so I can't really... Alright. There is something in this layout that is completely stuck, and I cannot remove it. Yeah. Then we're just gonna do it this way. I mean, if I can't do it, the conventional way, like just completely removing it, then not even with a hard reset. Well, I just completely quit out of rain meter, and that seemed to do the trick fine. Oh, this is really dark. what's the filler here? Oh yeah, that actually seems to work. I'm gonna put that on top here. And put the dock over it. That actually looks really nice. I like that. What do we have here? Oh, that's just a little thing for up there. Nice. How are you doing, mate? I'm doing pretty good. I'm working pretty hard on all kinds of stuff right now, honestly. Okay, yeah, I'm just gonna put the clock down there. And what is this visualizer? Oh, I think that's some kind of audio visualizer. Don't really need that. That's a wither thing. We have a player. Yeah, that's just the music player that I use. Can I also, duplicate this? Can I do that? I wonder. Because right now I just have one thing for everything. Like, I have one of those bars, but... That's about all that I've got. I mean, not that it matters too much, but it would be nice if I could have more than just the one. And otherwise, I just have to look up a different skin for that to work properly. That Jarvis shield thing, that just does not work for me. I do not like that. Um, You see, the thing with a lot of these layouts is you have to be a very specific kind of person to want to use many of these layouts with rain meter. Because you would be running into the caveat of it's either too light or too dark. And in some cases, the layouts just don't work. Like, straight up. Okay, I can actually work with something like this. I already have the application launcher. Like, technically, this is a application launcher. I just need to figure out how to exactly that works. Does it work? Nope. We have a recycle bin. I'd actually like to know something. Do we have more options for this? Like, can I add more folders and more buttons to this thing? Doesn't look like it. This is also looking for Photoshop. Okay. Then I know what I'm supposed to do. With some of these applications, you actually need to go... with all of these applications, you need to go into the actual folder of the application and... let's see, what version of Photoshop do I even use on this? 2021. It's not in this folder. Then it has to be installed into a different folder, right? Where did I install Photoshop CS2? Photoshop 2022. Oh, here it is. All right. Then I just need to look for the application launcher. Where is that file generally? Oh, it's supposed to be just Photoshop.exe. Right? Oh yeah, there it is. So I can just go into details for it. And then I can... Yeah. So in what directory is that? Just C? Oh, that's the wrong thing. C? Adobe? Adobe... Photoshop 2021 and then Photoshop.exe. Save and let's see if that works. Photoshop CC. Nope. That did not do the trick at all. It could be something as simple as this. But apparently it isn't. Let's just go crazy. Let's copy over this entire directory. And throw that whole thing in there. See what happens when I just do this. Maybe I just need to load it and unload it. Just load it all over again. Or But inside dream, dock, unload, load. Okay, we got a loading indicator and it actually works. The button works. Great. So I need to do that with every single application that I want to load up with this. Which, to be honest, isn't the most ideal, but it's the best thing that you can possibly do. And the thing with this particular application is that this is kind of the only way that you can run an application by doing something like this. This is kind of really the only way to do this, and that kind of sucks. I also would like to open. Also, just gonna close out of this. Brave browser should be the next one. Brave software, Brave browser. Application. Alright. And then this has to be the directory. And then you go brave.exe. Save. And refresh. See if that works. That works. And it works lightning fast too. Excellent. Yeah, the other files I don't really need to change, right? I mean, I never really use Word and Excel, so those two don't really make much sense for me to change those around. As much as I would like to do that, honestly. For the time being, let's actually just look through some other things that I could install on here. I was also thinking of getting a program like Window Blinds. Costs a little bit of money, but what you can get out of that is amazing. It's a really cool application that you can use to essentially... Let me actually show you what it is. I've never used it, but it would be really cool if I actually had it, because this makes it so that you can make an even more customized desktop. Look at this. So you can have classic version, you can have classic Windows styles back. You can change the entire look and feel of your entire desktop using it. Like, everything can be customized with it. And the best part about it is the community around this has built fantastic looking desktops for this. So yeah, that it's amazing that this kind of thing exists, and I would love to own it. How much does it actually cost? I'm curious. $12. Just for that one program. I would totally buy it and use it and have fun with it. I would absolutely do that. That would be awesome. And this is just a honeycomb, which is basically just a collection of buns that you can... assign certain applications to. And they actually have a lot of different applications that you can use also, which is great. But I kind of want to use something else. Let's see what these are. This is Spectrum V3. Oh. Hey! That actually kind of has a... synthwave feel to it. Kind of like my my whole layout here from Nerd or Die. That's cool. I didn't know they actually had that. I kind of feel like, though, that this is more for productivity applications, which is fine. I mean, I use Adobe Premiere Pro. I could potentially use that, but still. This is the ultimate status bar. Again, makes it look like a tiling window manager. If you were to use this on Linux, this could easily fit on there. That's really cool. Another social dock, material taskbar. Metro dock. Oh my god, no, I'm not gonna do that. I despise the Metro theme in Windows. And I always have despised it, and I always will despise it. It's awful. And the fact that people actually use it is just... the fact that it's, that it exists. Why does it exist? It should not exist. Game Launcher White. What? Okay. Simplistic bar. I kind of want something that doesn't have just a plain transparent background. That's kind of the problem that I'm facing here, because I would very much like an application that I could a theme that I could use, and that I don't have to worry about having so much crap on my desktop. Again, Shield OS, that is a freaking cool theme, but it comes with so much crap on top of it that I really don't want. Blue Vision Alpha. What even is this? Let's actually check this out. Oh, that looks very hacker man-y. But again, it comes with a lot of information on it. Actually, kind of like, I still really like the look of a lot of these, though, because so many of these are very well designed. And I reckon if you were to use any of these, you would have one hell of a cool setup. Like, I really like the look of this. Actually, did one of those have, yeah, I think that's got, like, a music, thing going on. Oh, oops. Yeah, that totally is a, little music thing. You know what I'm gonna do? What do we have here? Oh, but that's another one of those, things. Oh! Okay. That's pretty cool, but still not quite what I would like to use. I think I'm also gonna, try out bricks. And see if I like that. Let's first install Falling Knight. Open that up. And I would also like to install bricks. The other theme does not seem to open up here. That's fine. Not everything has to open immediately. And I actually prefer it that way, to be honest. All right. Let's see what we have. Bricks. And let's start with the launcher. Vertical. What do you have? That is a really small thing. Music folder doesn't open anything. That doesn't open anything. Okay, this is another case of, you need to assign these to a specific site or a specific folder or whatever. But these I actually need to assign manually. Okay. Because they don't open in here. That's a bit shitty. Oh, I think my dock also broke. Did it break? Hang on. Oh yeah, see, it just broke for a second. Oh god. I was actually kind of worried that I broke it and that it won't work anymore, regardless if I were to reload it or not. But it does work. Cool. Let's see what we have here. Ah, oh, this is another one of those launchers. It is going to launch Firefox. I would also like to know if there's any other icons that I could use. Because right now, a lot of these just have standard icons and such. But I think that this is supposed to be Thunderbird, by the way. I would like to know if I can actually change these things. So let me go into here. Hop into Rain Meter. I think it's in plugins. Nope. Visual elements. Nope, that's not in there either. Would it be in my documents folder then? Oh god, it gets saved to my documents folder. I don't know if I like that. Falling Knight, that's the one that I want to see. Okay, yeah, this does come with a bunch of different icons that I can assign to this program. Cool. It comes with a lot of them also. That's nice. Some of these appear to be very broken, though. Either that or they're just really low resolution. But I'm glad that these actually come with that. This actually comes with other icons besides the one besides the ones that are in here right now, because that means that I can actually assign applications that I want in here, which is nice. Let's see, is there a Chrome one in here? There doesn't appear to be one. Or maybe it's just under Google Chrome. Yeah. See Google Chrome right there. All right, let's edit this one. Let's see. Yeah, I'm just gonna take that name, copy it, and paste it right in here. And then it will execute something completely different. I gotta look for Brave Browser again in here. That's the wrong folder. It has to be in here then. Brave Software. There we go. Wait, what? Is it in here then? Oh yeah, right here. Lol. Alright. Then I'm gonna copy that. Paste it in here. brave.exe. Save it. And reloads. That changes to Google Chrome. Let's load it up. And that looks like it works. Awesome. I'm not gonna change every one of these individually as I'm doing a live stream right now, but it is still really cool that I can actually get that to work. And while I'm at it, I would also like to have the player in here. That's the wrong one. I need the one from Falling Knight. Music. Windows Media Player.ini. Let's see what that does. That shows the media player. Excellent. And we're gonna put that up top here. So these are just going to be my productivity apps. These are going to be folders. Actually, I need to check something real quick. Documents. This is gonna take up so much space. I can tell you right now. Okay, it doesn't really take up that much space just yet, but it will eventually take so much space. Resources. Okay, so I can actually also just use this as my resources thing. Can I? Nah, there aren't really all that many icons that I can change in here, and even if I could... Yeah, that settles that then. This is just going to be for my directories. These are going to be my productivity apps. And I'm also going to put this up top here. Also, what is this? Okay, yeah, that's nothing. Oh, oops. I also load up iTunes. And then there's WinApp. That doesn't do anything. Alright. Fair enough. There's also a nice little weather thing that doesn't seem to be working right now, so I'll probably have to change my time zone and everything in there. Alright, a little RAM indicator that can go right under there. So I'm just gonna put that right over here. HDD. Yeah, I would definitely like to have that over there. And I'm going to do this for all of my drives. Oh, this is just... What is this exactly? Oh, that's just how fast it's running, I guess. It's definitely not going to do it for me. Okay, that is going to show me my mail and shit. So that'll show me how many mails I got open. I'm gonna put that on the top right. Time and date, that would be nice to have, I guess. Oh, oops. Yeah, there we go. I'm gonna put that up here, down here underneath my dock. And let's see, there's also a time thing. I'm gonna use the 24 hours because I'm weird like that. There we go. Weather needs to be fixed, but I can fix that later. Let's also see what this has. Yeah. 12%. That doesn't really tell me much. I was hoping that the discs and whatnot would tell me a little bit more than what it actually does. This is a little mood. What? Okay. That's a weird thing to include in your thing. Recycle bin. Oh. That's cool. It's just a shame that it's so small. Alright, that's a Google search. There's a start menu. Ah, that's just a little start thing. Yeah, that's another one of those little music players. This one turns out, bricks turns out to be a failure. That's not very useful. Yeah. So far, this layout is not exactly impressing me, but it's at least somewhat functional. And that's more than what I can say from the other one that I tried to use. Coming up next, we have my personal favorite part of the whole thing. Linux. Let's play a little bit inside of here. I could also play around in Fedora Linux, since I've also not messed around with that much. But then again, I also don't really feel like messing around too much with that today. Maybe another day. Maybe another day. Arch Linux, I feel, is just a lot more fun to play around in. So that's the reason why I actually want to use this. There actually is a desktop environment that I've been meaning to play around with for a long while. And I never really took the time to actually do it. So this is actually going to be my chance to mess with it. Which I think is going to be really fun. Maybe it will be. Or maybe it won't be. I don't know. There's only one way to find out, and that's actually try it. Just gonna give it a shot. Let's see how well this is going to go, right? By the way, I don't know if this is a new thing with KDE Plasma that they're doing. The new wallpaper and such, but I really like it. I mean, it's a little bit busy. There's a little bit much going on, but... Hey! Oh, I just put in the wrong command there. Oops. I mean, yeah, it's a little bit busy for me. But it's still a relatively nice look. And I kind of like it. But... even though I kind of like it, I also really want to change it. Let's change it to Darkest Hour. I think that one looks really cool. Yeah, that's nice. Alright. Let's just leave it at that. And, there is a desktop environment that I've, been meaning to try for quite some time. And I hope that it's just as simple as this. It is not in... Pac-Man, so it has to be in this, right? Hmm. What's the package for Budgie? Is there even a package for Budgie? That's a better question, actually. Part of me kind of feels like there should be... a desktop environment for Budgie, right? Install Budgie, Arch Linux. Also, if you're wondering why exactly my theming is off, that's probably because of me running Alex Appearance on top of a KDE desktop. Which is probably messing around a little bit with some of my theming in here. a lot of my things are really off with this. So, I should probably swap that around real quick. Let's see if I can actually do that. Let's see, where is Alex's appearance? There it is. Oh, wait. Does it actually run on here? Huh. There it is. The application is broken. That's probably because of me running this on KDE Plasma. It's not liking something there. Okay. Oh, it needs to be Budgie Desktop. Okay, that's fair. Let's run Kitty again. And let's see if we can do this again. Budgie Desktop. Now that should work. I suppose I could also try this out on Debian, but I feel like Arch Linux is just way more fun. And this is my my testing VM anyway. Budgie has only 26 desktop? Only, what? Okay. That's not a lot of packages for a desktop environment. I feel like something is not right there, but okay. We'll see what happens. And for and again, I have not used this before at all, so I have no idea how well this is this will or how well this won't work. Knowing my luck, this is probably not going to go very well. All right, that's done. Normally, I would just go reboot. But let's just have some fun. Let's live dangerously. Oh yeah, there's also GNOME with this. That's cool. Alright. Let's see what this is. Okay. I kind of feel like something is not right. All right, let's start with doing this. Wallpaper automatically changes. All right. System settings doesn't start up. That is a very GNOME looking interface right there. Interface, I'm not gonna change that. Icons. Okay, now it just switched back to high color. Okay. I don't recall ever requesting for that to happen, but okay. Sure, my man. Do whatever you want. Navigation position is in the top right. 6 virtual desktops, that's fine. Windows. Yeah, there's not an awful lot in here that I can see that I can actually tweak much. But I'm pretty sure there's an awful lot more that I don't know of yet. Let's see what we are, what we're actually working with here. NeoFetch. Ah, yeah, that explains it. Essentially, what we're running on here is a GNOME-based desktop environment. So, a lot of what we're actually seeing in here are GNOME-based things. So you get a GNOME dock, you get this little menu right here, which is also kind of like GNOME. And you get things like that. And the thing with Budgie, I think, is that it doesn't come with much of anything. It does not come with a lot of stuff at all. It mostly just comes with the bare minimum. Oh my god, that looks awful. That looks absolutely horrendous. Okay. We are going to change that. I did not mean... Oh god, I did not mean to do that. Can I change anything at all in here? Doesn't look like I can do much. I despise that. I absolutely despise the look of this. Oh my god, I was hoping that this would actually be better than this. But no, this is awful. I mean, I'm sure you could get something like this to work fine. If you were willing to put in the time and the effort to make this work. Okay, yeah, that is a lot more like my aesthetic. It's just a shame that that I cannot change this. I mean, I'm sure... Surely I got some... different icon themes on here. I should at the very least have Breeze on here. Because I do get the Breeze cursors and whatnot, but I, for some reason... I'm not getting the Breeze icon theme, which is obnoxious. Look at how this. Look at this. This is hideous as all hell. How do you even do this? I legitimately have no idea how you do so, how you manage to make something that ugly. I mean, I'm sure you can make Budgie look good, but as it is, it's just a ginormous mess. GNOME does not boot at all. Maybe it will boot on Wayland. Nope. Xorg. No, GNOME does not work whatsoever. Okay. Then there's just one thing left for me to do inside of here. Hello? Oh yeah, there we go. Sudo pacman-rcns. And we're going to purge the GNOME desktop, or the Budgie desktop. That's a real shame. I was actually kind of hoping that this would be a fun experience, but no. Budgie is absolute crap out of the box. There are other things that I could try. Let's go LXDE. This is a really old desktop environment. This is not being developed anymore. This is completely obsolete at this point. But I feel like it would still be really fun to mess with. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna try this out and see how well this is going to work, or how well this is not going to work. That could also be a big possibility, of course. ESPC quit. And here we have it. Oh, we also have KDE open box. What even is that? That looks like KDE to me. But that's just running on Kwin. I have no idea what this is talking about when it's saying that it's running on OpenBox, but okay. That doesn't matter. LXDE. Lightweight X11 desktop environment. That's literally what LXDE stands for. And this is essentially what you're getting with a desktop like this. It's about as minimal as a desktop can be. You get a pretty nice looking file explorer in there. And there's a lot more other things that you can do inside of here. Let's see what we can make out of this. I legitimately want to check to test some stuff out in here. All right, there's customized look and feel. We're gonna switch that to Nordic. Icon theme. I kind of like that icon theme actually, but I prefer Advaita over that. Although this honestly fits the theme better. Yeah, we're just gonna stick with that. Mouse cursor. I kind of like this. This is more like a classic mouse cursor, which I kind of like. Window border, we can actually change to anything at this point. I really like... Let's see which one we can use. Bear. This one I typically use with LXDE. And from here, this is pretty much what we're getting. Oh, and we completely lost the cursor theme immediately. Nice. Not that it matters too much. All right. So the fun thing about LXDE is that it actually uses the open box window manager, which explains why this is so lightweight. You can run this on basically nothing. Let's see here. Oh, I despise the fact that I... Can I change my monitor settings in here? Yes, we can. The one problem with LXDE is that the graphic environment, like everything in here, it's very bare bones. Like, all of this, what you see is what you're what you see is essentially what you get. I would like to have Kitty in here. And I am going to iconify? I don't even know what that means, but let's see. HTOP. Yeah, it's running on so little hardware. It does not require anything whatsoever. Which makes it incredible for people who just want to use a Linux desktop with very little to no system requirements on top of it. Which is what I really like about it. It also comes with a music player. Which is literally just a music player. Let me actually check something. Can I get shared folders in this? I would like to see if I can get shared folders in this virtual machine. All right, I was just about to say, is this going to crash or something? Shared folders. The virtual machine is powered on. Oh, okay. So I cannot do that when this thing is powered on. Sure enough. Shut down. So now I can actually get into here. Options, shared folders, and enable it. And what I would like to do... Let's see, what kind of things can I add in here? What was I gonna do? you know what? That's nothing. Oh yeah, I know what I was gonna do. I was gonna add my entire point of view crap folder. And enable the share, finish, okay. And what I wanna do is I wanna see if I can play music from that shared folder. If this even will grab the shared folders that I have assigned to this thing. It may not, but there's only one way to find out, and that's to try it out and see what works. If it does work, then that would be freaking awesome. And... okay. We get our mouse cursor back also, which is fantastic. Let's see. I may need to use something a little more advanced than the default file explorer that comes with this. Other locations. Nah, it doesn't look like it really shows anything of note here. How does this even work? Let's see. Will the settings pop up at some point? There we go. Yeah, there's literally nothing that I can change on here while this is powered on. Then I think it's safe to say that I can't grab any shared folders from within here. So let's do it a different way. Let's just... let's see. I don't have a music pack on here, I just realized. Then there's just one thing that I can do about that, right? Go to incompetech.com and just download one of his songs. Royalty-free music. Yeah, get out of here. I'm using Firefox. This doesn't really have a built-in ad blocker, I think. Let's see what kind of music we can play in here. Let's do this one. And we're gonna download it as an MP3 player. Or as an MP3 file. We're gonna do the same with this. And we're also going to download this. It doesn't really have to be anything specific. I just want to test out the music player in this. Oh! That was a neat little effect. Can you do that again for me, please? Apparently not. But yeah, you get the idea. The fact that this is running on such a low-powered window manager, the OpenBox window manager... that makes this so incredibly lightweight to run. It also is really versatile. Because it can still be used on a desktop environment. There's a lot of desktop environments out there that need a specific window manager to run, I think. like KDE Plasma has KWin. A lot of GNOME-based desktop environments utilize Mutter. And then there's also XFCE, which also has an exclusive window manager. LXDE decides to go with OpenBox, and OpenBox can be applied to literally anything that you desire, which is really nice. And I reckon a lot of people would like to use something like that to, you know, have a very lightweight desktop environment. All right, we have downloads right here. This icon theme is pretty sweet, actually. Okay, it's apparently not as intuitive as that. I was hoping it would be, but that's apparently not the world we live in. So let's just open one of these files up and hope that it's going to work. Select application, view all applications. Where is it? Oh! It's not even in the list, okay. That's a little bit weird. Does it have to be in a specific... Hang on. Plug in Pulse Audio. Oh, okay, yeah. That actually works. Downloads. Sure. Maybe I can add music through this? Maybe? Okay, I legitimately have no idea what the hell I'm doing with this. Right, okay. We're gonna do something else. I think one music player that I always used on Linux was Clementine. So let's see if that will actually work. And if that does work, then Alex Music just freaking sucks. I'm sorry, but if this doesn't work, then it just does. Then it just sucks as a program. I mean, maybe I did some. Maybe I'm doing something horribly wrong with the program. Maybe I just need to know how to use that program. But I think it still should just work, and it doesn't. Oh, this is just a terminal application. Let's see, Clementine. Click here to add some music, add new folder, downloads, open. And look what happens. Okay, I'm just gonna, leave that as it is. See, that was just the exact thing that I was talking about. Nothing ever works for me. And when it does work, it's just some kind of freaking miracle if it does work. Okay, so we ruled out Chaos, Budgie, and some applications in LXDE. Now, that was just my personal experience. I don't know how you guys are going to experience this kind of shit, but not that it matters anymore. Yeah. So, Originally, I was going to do a little bit of editing also in this live stream. But I think that this has been going on for long enough at this point. And it's about time that we move on from this. I will probably be doing a editing stream in the future, but not just not today. So that's been it for today. I'm gonna put aside my my headset, and I well, thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, drop a like, subscribe, and blah, 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 blah. You know how it goes. I'm not gonna repeat, I can't speak right now. Okay, this is a wonderful outro. This is a very good outro. Thank you for watching, and as always, stay passionate. Bye bye. All right, I'm gonna get out of here.